数百年前生まれた2つの種族、イミチ族と吸血族。己の血を活性化させ驚異的な力を発揮する一族、イミチ族。そしてイミチ族と対立し他人の血を吸収再利用して戦う一族、吸血族。4人は幾度も対立し互いの正義を主張し合っていた。これはその種族と4人の女の物語。
OK! Bring it on!
Welcome everyone to Onechanbara, not Onechanbara, I was about to say Onechanbara. Onechanbara Z2 Chaos. Okay, so obviously just by looking at this game already, you can kind of tell that the game is over-sexualized, and well, yes, it definitely is. So this game, I mean, it's a PlayStation 4 game. So the graphics are up there, you know, as opposed to like many other games that I've recently played that have been for older consoles, so it's definitely a nice twist here. But like I said, this game, I mean, it's received mixed reception, just because the gameplay is pretty solid, I would say, but also repetitive. The story is very weird, kind of stupid at some points, you know. But it's just received criticism because of how maybe sexist it can be, you know, all over-sexualized characters. Kind of like Hyperdimension Neptunia, you know, or Dead or Alive is also like that. So yeah, this game is interesting, for sure, but I mean, like I keep saying, just by looking at the characters, you'll be like, oh my god, man, this game was made for one thing. Oh my god. Sex sells, people. Sex sells. Okay, so the game is actually not very long, at least the story. I don't know if I'll be doing other things like mission or, you know, what else was it? Was it quest? I don't know, but there's more options, more missions. But for now, just the story. Like I said, the story's not too long. It's not going to take too long. Not too long in the Let's Play. Let's see. I'm just checking to see here if all the options are correct. There we go. Default. Lock-on key. No. What the... Okay, so I'm going to change lock-on to L1. It's very awkward with R1. Most games that I've played in my life, you lock on with the L side, not the R side, which makes this game weird if you're doing the R side, at least for me. Okay, let's see, lock on type keyhole, that's fine, that's okay. That should be okay, alright. Let's go ahead and start, let's do story. Let's do a new game, here we go. Casual and medium, okay. So, this Let's Play, I mean, honestly, I don't know how many freaking side quests and stuff there's gonna be, you know, like if there's actually stuff you can get outside of just the progression for the story. But I'm gonna make this a very casual run, and literally the difficulty says casual here. You know that in Let's Plays when I do a casual run, I just choose the easiest mode and just talk about the game and just have fun with it. So it's convenient that in this game, casual is actually casual. Yeah, I'm gonna take this Let's Play very, you know, casual-like, you know, I'm not a hardcore gamer when it comes to this game here, because I don't know too much about it. I mean, I've made it pretty freaking far into the game, so I know, like, the controls and all that stuff, but, you know, and the basic gameplay mechanics. But as far as technical stuff, I don't know. So yeah, just, you know, just gonna have fun with this Let's Play. Hopefully y'all enjoy it too, because, like I keep saying, it's a very strange game. Since ancient times, the Vampiric Clan and the Baneful Bloodline have been locked in a vicious battle for supremacy. Much blood has been spilled in the name of this war, and the fighting has continued well into the modern era. Kagura and Saya are schoolgirl sisters raised together by the Vampiric Clan and rank among their strongest warriors. Haya and Saki are assassin sisters descended from the Baneful Blood and represent their lineage with esteem. These two pairs of sisters first met in combat when the Vampiric Clan hatched a diabolical conspiracy. So they reveal, in their attempts to best one another in Onechanbara-style swordplay, no deciding blow was ever struck. Rather, Kagura and Saya came to realize, through much struggle and hardship, that their true enemy was not the Baneful Blood. Their own adoptive mother, Queen Carmilla, was found to be the mastermind behind everything. She'd meant for the two to die by each other's blades, but her convoluted plot was discovered and thwarted. Desperate, she holed herself up in her castle, intending to lure Kagura and Saya in and eliminate them herself. But their sisterly bond was stronger than the corrupt matriarch could ever imagine, and her troops were decimated. Aya and Saki bore witness to this spectacle, and both sides lost the will to fight. Just as it seemed the truce was in the cards for these two warring clans, however, the call of their bloodlines overwhelmed them, and once more, their blades were drawn. Okay, so that's the backstory to this game, and you're like, what the fuck? Well, I mean, obviously this game is a sequel to the 360 game, the Bikini something, I don't even know what the hell. So, I guess if you play this game first, you don't know much about the whole freaking story, you know? Anyway, I'm just going to go ahead and skip all these options and just kind of show you myself. So, I always have trouble with this first battle here, because, I mean, it is sort of a training, but it really is all just about attacking, pretty much. Shit. Now, you can't actually die in here. You can't. Whoa. No. Anyway, you can press the square for light attacks, or you can press the triangle for stronger attacks. You can also jump by tapping X lightly, you'll just do a normal jump, but by tapping X for a little bit longer, so not tapping it, actually you'll do like a freaking charge kick or something. Anyway, now here's Aya. So Aya and Saki. And yeah, sometimes I'll be talking over the voices while during the gameplay, just because, I mean, come on, it's the gameplay. Like right now, so they're talking. Luckily you can read, you know. Yeah, luckily. Oh shit, I'm doing so badly right now, people. Like, I'm getting hit way too much. So you can also do this, locking on, and sometimes it kind of works. But how do you change fucking target stones? I don't even know. I thought it was that button, but it's not working. Keep going. Am I even attacking? Dude. Yeah, so you can also do combos like by in the air. You can do that and then do your combos in the air if you want to. Like that. But I mean, it really depends on, you know, what you want to do. Shit. Get out of the way, dude. Or girl, whatever. There's a lot of other mechanics in the game that I'll be getting to in a bit. So, at the moment, it's just like the intro battle. But like I said, you can't lose, but you'll get a grade or rank, depending on how much damage you do and how much damage you take. That's terrible. Oh my god. Okay, whatever. Now, everything in this game is very weird, sometimes a bit cheesy, a bit corny, but whatever, you know. I mean, like I said, this game, it did get mixed reception, so it kind of shows, but I guess it sold, I mean, it didn't sell amazing, but I guess it sold pretty well, pretty decent, because of its over-sexualized characters, you know. It's just a fun game, because back when I last played Hyperdimension Neptunia, and yes, I stopped after like 11 parts, but back when I started it, I was like, this game is going to be a weird let's play, just because the characters are over-sexualized, and I guess that always alters people's perceptions of the game, you know? This game, it's pretty much the same. So, we'll see.
Fallen quite a ways.
Aya,
Ain't this a kick in the teeth, being stuck down here with you.
Believe me, the feeling's mutual.
The hell you just say? Oh, you wanna finish what we started then?
I think there are bigger issues, like Saya. Our sisters are still missing, Kagura.
Oh crap, you're right. Where is Saya? And don't you dare say my name again.
Search and rescue it is then. Let's get a move on, Kagura.
I'll make this work.
Okay.
Oh,
finally the
you?
Gameplay. So yeah, we are now going to be fighting some... This is weird. We're going to be fighting zombies, alright? So, I mean... could this game get any weirder, people? I mean, it's funny because on the back of the cover art, like, you know, it says, oh yeah, like, you know, like you're these girls, these hot girls, like, it sounds like Bikini Girls plus zombies. You're like, what the hell kind of combination is that? I mean, seriously? Bikini Girls fighting zombies. It is the strangest combination ever. Okay, so... It's basically a hack and slash game, if you couldn't already tell. You're gonna be seeing a lot of, you know, weak enemies, so that's typically what hack and slash means, you know, weak enemies versus you pretty much owning everybody. Kind of like, you know, what is that, is it Dynasty Warriors? I haven't really played that series, so, but, Hyrule Warriors is like that, yeah, because Hyrule Warriors is a, like, a combination of Dynasty Warriors and also Legend of Zelda. But yeah, I mean, hack and slash games are, they could either be hit or miss. This one is... more on the miss side, according to many people. Even though other people say the gameplay is solid, so maybe hack and slash games aren't pure hit and miss, and maybe there could be like an in-between. Maybe some people argue this is an in-between one. It's not a great hack and slash in terms of the gameplay, but, I mean, it's whatever. I guess everybody has their own view on things, you know, so that's cool, I guess. So, wait, can I just go like the other way around? Hold on. Man, I'm being dumb here, just killing. Oh, let's see. What about this way? What's over here? No, it's still locked. Okay. I gotta kill all these freaking enemies. I mean, yeah, usually when that happens at the gate, you gotta kill all the enemies. But then usually it's a round two. What the? Get over here. Get over here, dude. You must die.
I could totally do even better next time.
Rank A. Okay, whatever, so let's see. I gotta just keep going this way now. So I guess we're kind of in an underground little minecart thing. Oh, shit. Whoa. Oh, no. Sirens in the background. Sirens in the background. God damn it. Can there ever be a freaking video, like, just one video where there's no sirens in the background? There always is. You know, there always is. Kill them all. Kill them all. Hack and slash away. Yeah, this game is gory, by the way. So much freaking blood. If you couldn't already tell, you know. Alright, so right now I'm in the, do you see how I have the aura around me? When you have the aura around you, you can actually press the square and triangle buttons to unleash an extremely powerful attack to everybody. So you can either use that or you can save that. You know, whatever really suits you best in that situation. So I think for now I'm gonna save. There's not too many enemies at the moment. I guess I'll just keep going down. Or somewhere. Maybe not. There's not too many enemies left, though. Yeah, see, some enemies have a lot more health than others. Like, these shield guys or whatever, they have some pretty decent health by this point in the game. Like, see, you do so many attacks and they still... Like, they're still living! Look at this shit! What the hell is this? Okay, you're not dead yet, really? There you go, now you are. Oh man, so many more. Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and use my attack. This one. See that? That's your ultimate attack right there. That is amazing. That is some amazing shit. You can cause some crazy, crazy combo damage, whatever, with that attack. But again, you have your limited bars. I mean, there's a lot of bars on the left side, as you can see. You have your health bar. And you have your other smaller bars, which I can't even, like, sometimes tell what the hell they are because it's so small. Like, the damn size of them, you know? So... Whoa, 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 what the hell was that? Alright. Too much health. Too much health for you freaking people. There we go. Okay. I mean, usually once you like kill these guys, there's always like a little, like a few stragglers left, you know, that you gotta kill. Such as right now, pretty much what's happening. There we go. Rank S, ooh. So the gates are down. Oh shit, what the hell are these? Whoa. Just came out of nowhere. Damn, look at all these freaking enemies over here. They're all spawning like right over there. Okay, by the way, you can heal by pressing square and X, I believe. And holding it. Which I'll show in just a bit, because there's too many freaking enemies at the moment. Okay, here's what I'm gonna do. Damn, such freaking slaughterish. Okay, let's try it. Yeah, see that right there. You just heal a little bit. So yeah, your health is the biggest bar that you can clearly see on the left side. So if you didn't look at that, just like rewind the video. I healed a bit. Actually, I'll just show it again soon though. Oh my god. Freaking... That's it. I've had enough. I'm using my move. I kill a bunch. Oh shit, more just spawned though. What am I doing? Yeah, see, this like, what the hell are they, like, gargoyles or something? Man, these guys are pretty crazy. Well, in both damage and health, though. You know, both of them. What? I didn't mean to do that. Yeah, you can also change weapons. You can use your sub-weapon. The sub-weapon doesn't actually, you know, do as much damage. But I guess it's still pretty convenient, you know? It just depends on like what situation you're currently in. But that's really all like the technicalities of the game that even I don't know too well. Because apparently this game can get pretty deep in the gameplay if you are actually like a huge fan of this or something and you actually study it or something. Apparently it can get pretty crazy. That's what I've heard at least. Heal up. Oh shit. Okay, now I'm kind of lost as to which way I need to go. I don't actually know. Oh my god. So many freaking things. Holy crap. Look at that shit. Jesus. Damn hack and slashes, huh? Well, I mean... The thing about this one is that even though it's a hack and slash, the enemies still have kind of a lot of health. In other hack and slash games, like, let's say Hyrule Warriors, the pathetic enemies, man, they die so damn easily. It makes it more fun, you know, just doing that. It really does. God. Attack! Attack all of you! It's your ultimate power. Oh my god, why are there so many freaking enemies? Too many zombies here, man. Way too many. I need to make a run for it. Oh my god. Oh my god. Shit. The thing is, though, I'm about to make it to another area, like a big long cutscene. But... I probably need to end the video because I'm going to keep these around 20 minutes like always, you know? So, yeah, I need to just kill these freaking zombies here and then end it, probably. There's so freaking many of them, though. Wait, you know what I should do? I keep forgetting this. I need to refresh the blade. I didn't talk about this, but if you press... I'll talk about that later.
check out how big it is.
Big enough that you could keep any pet you wanted down here.
I think this might be a little much for your average pet. The size of animal it calls for probably doesn't...
Okay, anyway, if you press the R1 button or L1 if you don't actually change the controls, then you can refresh the blade. If you If you refresh the blade, you will actually do higher damage. And that's part of the reason why it was taking me so long to kill these monsters, these zombies, because I didn't refresh the blade, I forgot to. Anyway, next time we're gonna go down there, jump down there. So if you enjoyed this episode in any way, please be sure to leave a like, I would appreciate that very much. Thank you, and I will see you all next time. Bye-bye.